Students, this is class number 12. In this class, let us have a simple discussion about universal set. You all may have learnt this in your lower classes. So you have learnt, you people are familiar with this word universal set. From that name itself, students, universal. Universal means universe. Universe means whole world, so full world. That biggest set is called as universal set. Look at this, students. You take, so right, usually we represent universal set by the capital letter U. So we represent universal set by, so the capital letter U. Look at this, students. U. So U is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So A. Let us write the subsets for that. Subset A. So 1, 2. Next. Subset B. 2, 3, 4. Next. C. Subset C. 4, 6, 7. For these three sets, this set becomes universal set. For these sets, this set becomes a universal set. So which is the biggest set which contains all these sets? A biggest set which contains all these sets is called universal set. So now I go for defining that. So a set definition. A set from which elements are chosen to form a particular set. So to form a particular set. Is called universal set. Look at this simple definition, students. A set. This is a set from this set we have chosen elements. For this set, I have chosen these two elements to form a particular set. Here I found one more particular set by using elements of this universal set. So here I found one more set. Found one more set by using elements of this biggest set. This type of sets are called as universal set. Universal set. A set. Universal set is a set from this set elements are chosen. We choose elements to form a particular set. So is called universal set. I hope you understood, students. Now next let us go for operations on sets. So next, let us go for operations on set. Before that, you go for note. So for the universal set, we represent universal set by using rectangles. So remember this note. So to represent universal set, usually we use this rectangle. So universal set U. So universal set, to represent universal set, so we use rectangles. To represent sets, So we use circles usually to represent sets. We use circles, students. So look at this circle, set A. Next, one more circle, set B. One more circle, set B. So next, set C, so on. Set A, set B, set C, so on. Usually to represent sets, we use circles. To represent rectangles, to represent universal set, we use rectangles. These diagrams are called as Venn diagrams. So what are these called? Venn diagrams. Venn diagrams. So Venn diagrams. So Venn diagrams. These graphical, right, representation are called Venn diagrams. Venn diagrams. We use these Venn diagrams to explain graphically the relation between the sets. We use these Venn diagrams to explain the relationship between the sets. So to explain the relationship between the sets through graphs, through figures, so we use these things and they are called as Venn diagrams. So let's go for next concept, students. Let us move on to one more concept. So that is, so right, so next, so operations on sets. So operations, on sets. Operations on sets. First one, union of sets. Union. First one. Union of sets. So look at this, students. I take two sets. Set A. So union of sets, we represent symbolically. In symbols, we represent union of two sets by using this symbol. Union, U. So union of sets, right? We use that symbol, union. For that union, we use this symbol. For that intersection, we use that reverse form, right, of this symbol. Okay, look at this, students. You take two sets, set A, 1, 2, 3. You take one more set, set B. So 2, 3, 4, 5. So the union of these two sets, is represented by A union B. A union B. The union of these two sets is represented by A union B, and it contains, it is a set of all elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So look at this, students. Union of two sets is the set of all those elements which are either belong to set A or belong to set B. Clearly, so till you observe these elements, union of two sets of rare upon the set of all elements, and all the ottige bariyodu anta without repetition. Look at this, one is an element, one belongs to set A, two belongs to set A or set B. These elements belong to either to the set A or to the set B. ಇದರಲ್ಲಾದರೂ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್.
So definition. So union of two sets. So union of two sets. Union of two sets A and B. A and B is A union B. A union B is the set of all elements. Is the set of all elements. Set of all elements which are either from A or from B. So which are either from A, these elements are either from A or from A, B. So right. So one is element from A, two is element from A or from B. So right, three is an element either from A or from B. So union of two sets A and B is A union B. We represent union of these two sets by this symbol, and is the set of all elements. Set of all elements. This is also a set which are either from. So we collected these elements either from A or from B, right? So which are the collection? Right, enough. I hope you understood. Union of two sets. So next, note. So note, so right, while collecting elements to the union, you should not repeat. Don't go for repeating. Don't write the same element more times. One element, two on the very well. ಎರಡರಲ್ಲೂ ಟೂ ಇದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಸರಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ರೈಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಸೊ ಸೊ ರೈಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆನ್ ಸೊ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆನ್ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಸೊ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ Properties on union. Union of sets. So properties on union of sets. First one. So A union B is equal to B union A. A union B is same as B union A. This law is called as commutative law. So this is, this one is called as, this condition is called as, this rule is called as commutative rule, commutative axiom or commutative law. That means A union B is always equal to B union A. For example, so you take A is equal to 1, 2. So B is equal to, so 2, 3. Now you go for finding A union B. You find A union B. So A union B. So A union B, it is a collection of all elements from both A and B without a repetition. A union B, it is a collection of all elements from both A and B without a repetition. So 1, so 2, 3. So this is A union B. Next is B union A. So B union A, again it is the collection of all elements. So from both B and A, so right, we collect. So 2, 3. So 2, 3, 1. So I told you students, order. So in sets, order doesn't matter. Writing 1, 2, 3 is same as writing 2, 3, 1. So while collecting elements to the set, order does not matter. This implies A union B, so is always equal to, so B union A. A union B is equal to B union A. I hope you understood, students. So this is the property one. So property two, so right, is called as commutative law. So this law is called as a commutative law. Now let's go for one more property. Next property is second property. A union B. Union C is same as A union. B union C. Look at this, students. This property, this condition is called as associative law. What is this called? Associative law. It is called as associative. That is, union is associative. We call that as union becomes associative. So that is it. Now you only cross check students what actually ill yen madidivappa andre ivereduku bracket hakidivi ade bracket na ee kade bandaga change madidivi aste associative la andre yenappa andre brackets na change madidre values change aagabadu. Look at this. So this set, the elements of this full set is equal to the elements of this full set. So these two sets, this set is equal to this full set. Even if you change the brackets, elements of this set remain same as elements of this set. ಈ ಸೆಟ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಏನಿರ್ತವೋ ಈ ಸೆಟ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅದೇ ಇರ್ತವೆ. ಇವೆರಡು ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟಿವ್ ಲಾ. ಸೊ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ನಂಬರ್ 3, ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಯುವರ್ ಓನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಚೆಕಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಸೊ ಎ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಪೈ, ಸೊ ಎ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಪೈ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಆಸ್ ಪೈ ಈಸ್ ನಲ್ ಸೆಟ್. So A union pi is same as A. So A union pi is same as A. So next one, so A union A is same as A. So next one, so A union U is same as U. So A union U is same as U. So here U is universal set. What is that you called a universal set? I hope you are understanding properties, students. So right, these are the properties on union of sets. If you have doubt, choose particular set and go for cross checking this. ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಸೆಟ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಇವನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೀವೇ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೋದು ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸಿನೆಲ್ಲ. ಎ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ all elements from both the sets, so without repetition. So you should know, usually in sets we won't go for repeating elements, right? Okay, I hope you understood, students. These are the properties on union of sets. Now let's go for intersection. So union, intersection of sets, right? So now let's move on to intersection of sets. So intersection of sets. Intersection of two sets. A and B are two sets. Intersection of So definition, look at this words, let A is equal to 1, 2, 1, 2, so B is equal to 2, 3, 4, so C is equal to 3, 4, 5. So for this intersection of two sets, we use this symbol. This is the symbol we use for that intersection of two sets. Look at this, students. So right, A intersection B
contains all those elements which are common to both A and B. The elements which are common elements, one is present in A, but one is not there in B. It won't be there in intersection. Intersection ಗೆ ಏನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡರಲ್ಲೂ ಇರುವಂತದ್ದು ಕಾಮನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಕಾಮನ್ ಟು ಬೋತ್ ದ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಟು ಬೋತ್. ರೈಟ್, ಸೊ ಟು ಟು ಈಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಟು ಬೋತ್. ರೈಟ್, ಕಾಮನ್ ಟು ಬೋತ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಇಂಟರ್ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಬಿ ಇಂಟರ್ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ. ಸೊ ಬಿ ಇಂಟರ್ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ, ಸೊ ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಇಂಟರ್ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. 3 4. Right, 3 4. Right, A intersection C, A intersection C. So A intersection C, so A intersection C. So tell me elements of A intersection C. So right, A intersection C, A 1 2, C 3 4 5. We don't have common elements from A and C. A ಮತ್ತು C ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಮನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ನಲ್ ಸೆಟ್, ಎಂಟಿ ಸೆಟ್. ವಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಎಂಟಿ ಸೆಟ್ ಬೈ ಪೈ. ಸೊ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್. ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ಸೆಟ್ಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್, are called disjointed. So we call A and C as disjoint sets. So right. So now I go for defining intersection. So intersection. So definition. Intersection of two sets A and B is the set of all common elements, set of all common elements from both A and B, common to both is a set of all elements common to both the sets A and B. So intersection of two sets A and B is intersection of two sets A and B is A intersection B is A intersection B is set of all elements, set of all elements set of all elements common to both the sets A and B. So define intersection of two sets, students. So define intersection of two sets. So A and B are two sets. Intersection of two sets A and B is, we represent that by A intersection B, and is the set of all elements common to both the sets A and B. I hope you understood, students. So common elements na tagondu set maadi, we call that set as intersection set, intersection of two sets. So right, now so remember the following. So right, okay students, we shall stop this class. We shall continue in the next class. Thank you.